We're here at GET 2016, which is the second Global Forum on Emergency Telecommunications, and I'm very pleased to be joined by Alan Kuresevic, who is the Vice President of Engineering for SES TechCom.
Good morning.
Good morning. Now, I know that you're involved in satellite technology. Perhaps we could talk a little bit about the connection with satellite technology and emergency disaster communication.
For sure. The SES is one of the prime satellite operators in the world, and we see the satellite technology as the technology to be used in the emergency disasters. The advantage of satellite technology is definitely there because it's available worldwide. It doesn't rely on the terrestrial infrastructure, so it can be actually very resilient in terms of the disaster response, as well as easy to deploy and both in terms of the equipment and the time to get to deploy. So I think satellite technology is the obvious choice to address the disaster telecommunication in case of emergency.
Now, you're also involved in something called emergemc.lu. Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about it. It's a global VSAT-based multi-layer communications platform.
For sure. Emergemc.lu is actually a private-public partnership between Luxembourg government and three Luxembourg companies, SES High Tech and Luxembourg Air Ambulance, in which actually we are providing the worldwide system to support humanitarian workers in disasters to establish the early hours telecom infrastructure and IT infrastructure. We're actually looking to fill the gap of early hours of communication, basically at the times where the most of the lives can be saved. So basically moving from what used to be around Haiti disaster, 3 days to set up communication, to basically a few hours after disaster to have a communication running.
And in terms of the importance of ICTs in disaster preparedness and response, perhaps we could talk a little bit about that.
For sure. The ICT is actually definitely a set of number of very useful tools that can be used in the disaster response. It helps us to make the things more efficient, more faster, but it has to be said that these are just the tools. I think the important thing here is to mention that the people who operate them needs to be trained. The logistics has to be there to support these tools to be deployed in the region. And also the holistic picture of background support for the people, both in the country where disaster happens and in the world, has to be there for these tools to work.
There have been a number of conversations going on at this forum discussing the synergies between sustainable development and emergency disaster response. Perhaps we could talk a little bit about that.
Yes, for sure. The emergency disaster response per se is not, let's say, a cheap activity. It requires lots of investment in the equipment, in people, in training, capacity building, and so on. And it actually takes place or being deployed only in case of the emergency. So the time when the emergency is not there, that same type of equipment, same people, same knowledge can be used actually for sustainable development activities. And this is something that I think makes sense to synergize on the long term. We have also looked at this in terms of our emergency telecom system. And for instance, in the times when we don't have emergency support, we use the system for e-health projects like SatMed in order to provide e-health infrastructure for developing countries.
What do you hope will be a key or some of the key takeaways from this forum?
Well, the key takeaway is I'm very pleased to see very good cooperation between governments and the private industry. I think this is a really good opportunity to meet people at the both sides of the, let's say, activities. And I think it's very important to see there's more and more partnerships being built in the area of emergency disaster response, which basically optimize the solutions and makes them more sustainable and more efficient in the future.
Well, thank you very much indeed for joining us in the studio today, and we wish you all the best for the future.
Thank you for having me here. Thank you very much.
Thank you.